Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss. Week one of my Ship Your App cohort is in action. App builders are sharing great tools, and I wanted to share this with you now. Adnan from my cohort actually shared that Lenny's newsletter has an incredible amount of products, in fact, $10,000 worth of well-known tools that we can use to vibe code, make content, talk to our computer, and so much more. Now, when I first took a look at that page, I thought it's too good to be true. It's got to be a scam. Until I discovered it's created by Lenny Rachitsky, who's a former Airbnb product lead and now newsletter creator. I have absolutely no affiliation to the guy whatsoever, but for $200 a year to subscribe to his newsletter, you get access to all those deals and leverage his social clout in Silicon Valley. And plus, I think it's great because it's upskilling all of us for the future by using vibe coding tools and other AI tools that can really make amazing things. And that got me to thinking, Lovable is one of the free tools, a free year of Lovable Pro, and it's what my students in Ship Your App are using, so let's give it a go. The app I'm about to vibe code is inspired by my friend Jerry Potter, who messaged me on LinkedIn and says, I was intrigued by what you said in our chat about entrepreneurs and creators being able to offer their own app as a lead magnet. So let's do that right now. Jerry's got an incredible video on his channel about how he's using ChatGPT to get views. So I thought, there's an idea for a lead magnet app. I'll use another free tool I got in Lenny's newsletter, Whisperflow, to make the prompt with my voice. I'd like you to create an app, get your YouTube videos recommended by AI, that generates video titles, descriptions, and tags designed to be favored by AI recommendation algorithms. The user should start with a single input field for their email address to gain access, and when they do, they need to describe their video idea in a text box. Once that's done, they can click a generate button, and the output will be title, description, and tags ready for the user to copy and paste. Everything will be generated using AI. Okay, I think that's a solid initial prompt to build my app. I'll hit enter and let Lovable go to work. And as you can see, it's generating beautiful hero images and my index and everything else needed for this lead magnet that I can put down below in the description. And look at this, perfect. I've created a beautiful YouTube AI optimization tool, and actually it doesn't look too bad at all. Now I can click the edit button that's down here, and I can edit elements on this page without using any more credits inside Lovable. Now you see here, this text isn't very readable. Well, no worries, I can change that. I'll click here onto edit styles, and then I can go in and change colors to really anything I want. That definitely stands out a lot better on my app, and that's easily done. I just click save down here at the bottom, and I've updated my app. So one single prompt vibe coded me a potential lead magnet that I can give in the description to this video to gather email addresses. So I'm going to click the preview button here to open it in a new tab, and I'll give it a go by typing in a quick email and see if it works. Okay, now the app is asking me to describe my video idea, so I'll paste in the idea for this video, turn your app into a lead magnet that actually works, and we'll click generate optimized content to see what comes back. And look at this, it's actually generated some titles and a rough description. At the moment, it looks quite generic, so I'm guessing this is mock data, but don't worry, we can fix that with another prompt. If you like what you see so far, throw a like and subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Now, at this point, you'd be right to ask, well, where is that email address actually going that people type in before they access the tool? And that's a very good point. It's probably just being lost at the moment. Well, this is what I show in my Ship Your App cohort, is that you can connect a database. In this case, it's called Supabase, and we'll just click that. Then we click Connect Supabase. And before you go ahead and do this, you'll need to set up a free account on Supabase. I'll link that down below. I already have created a Create a Magic account, and I can just authorize Lovable to use it. And now I can create a new project. We'll call it YouTube AI Optimizer, generate a password, select a server close to us, and create. That's all I needed to do. Now you'll see it's ready to connect here in Lovable. And you'll see it telling me Supabase is connected, and Lovable over here has taken the liberty of setting things up for me as well. So here's my next prompt. When the user enters their email, that should be sent to a table in my database, and they should also have to confirm their email using Supabase Auth. That's pretty solid. Let's send that and see what happens. Okay, you can see this is all being written to Supabase for me. Very, very simple and easy. I just click to apply and Lovable does the rest. And look at this, it seems to have wrapped up. And if I go over to Supabase, we've got a lovely table here to store our user emails all as they come in. So let's refresh the app over here and test it again. First, I'll type in my email, and now it's telling me to check my email before I can use the app. This is exactly what we want for an AI-generated lead magnet. And look at this, indeed, I've received an email saying confirm, so I'll go ahead and do that. And yes, I'm in. The moment I confirm, I can use the app. This is a really good sign. If we look here at the refresh database, we'll see one email exists. That's our very first lead inside our AI app. Now, remember when we were typing in our ideas, we were just getting mock results back. Let's implement AI to actually generate usable results. When the video idea is typed in and the optimize button is clicked by the user, you'll use Gemini 2.0 Flash to generate results. Remember to ask me for my API key. That's all we should say, and then we send that off to Lovable to go to work. It's thinking away, and the first thing it says is, yes, you need to add your API key. Not only does it ask for that, but it tells you where to get a Gemini API key, and also it has a button to add it. So let's do this. And boom, it's literally taken me straight to my Gemini account where I can copy my API key and paste it into Lovable. So I've copied that, and then we'll click Add API Key. You put it in here, and you can be sure that it's secure and it's not being shared in your code. Now it's thinking away and it says, perfect, I'll create the edge function and update your app to use Gemini 2.0 Flash for generating results. And we're in, so let's try that description one more time, and hopefully now it should be using Gemini 2.0 Flash. And we can actually see it's work. Turn apps into lead magnets, no code, AI lead magnet, build an app in minutes, stitch PDFs. I love this. An optimized description here. Well, maybe we could remove some of those chapters, but it's given some excellent trending tags here. I really like this. It's a lead magnet ready to go. You can test it out yourself using the link down below. Big shout out and thanks to Jerry for the inspiration. Go and watch his video on how he used ChatGPT to optimize his YouTube videos, and also check out his YouTube channel and throw him a sub as well. Oh, by the way, a lead magnet is no good unless other people can access it, so I'll just click publish here and just hit the publish button to let it go live. By the way, this is exactly the kind of stuff I teach in my course, Ship Your App. Super early bird registration for the next cohort in September is open now, and it ends on Sunday, so use the link down below if you're interested in joining me, and I really hope to see you in the next cohort. By the way, cohort number 2 is in action right now. We're inside week 1, just coming to the end of that, and we had clinic 1 live last night. It was really cool, and I wanted to peel back the curtain a little bit and show you what a clinic looks like. Every single week we gather together here and we find out where we're at and what we're doing, what we've learned, what we're hoping to work on. No stupid questions, so no matter how small it sounds or how big and crazy it sounds, we can get into it.
The challenge I've been chatting to you about and that everybody's been talking about here is UI UX. I've discovered a tool called UX Pilot. This for me is probably one of the key challenges of many of the apps that are coming out of the AI tools. All the apps are looking the same. Get your UI and then use that as an input into the coding tool.
Now, you know what? Werner had a really good point and a cool tool to share on the call. So let's test it out. So there you go. One of the problems we face with AI vibe coding tools is all the designs look the same. So I thought I'd try out UX Pilot to make my lead magnet app look a little bit better. We'll just create an account with Google. Okay, now it's set up. I've got to give it the context and generate. Well, this is the first result we got, and I gotta say, I'm not too happy with that. It could be better. But look, it's got deep design that allows it to generate more detailed and high-quality designs, so I'll switch that on, use double the credits, and we'll try again. I'm also going to switch to a hi-fi design to give more color. It's working away and generating my design, and here it is, and do you know what, actually? That looks really slick and really nice. I quite like that. So now I've made it fit the screen, and I'll take a quick little screenshot of this. Now we'll go back to Lovable one more time, and I'm going to go ahead and attach that image. Make the whole app look more like this. And now you see we've gone from a rather generic tool to something that's more influenced by the UX Pilot tool we just used. Much slicker, much nicer, and potentially more unique. And here we are logged in one more time. We'll generate just to make sure it still works. And boom, there we go. All of our ideas right back, ready to copy and use on our YouTube video. While we could spend ages dialing in the UI and UX of this app, there was the other side of the coin shared in my cohort yesterday during the live clinic. Hear what Garen had to say.
If you're brand new to product design or app design, you should go to ChatGPT and you should ask it, what is a minimum viable product? Get the absolute minimum thing you need to get it online and get it functional. It doesn't need to be pretty. It doesn't need to have all of the bells and whistles. What is the minimum thing you can do before trying to build it completely out and get it in people's hands and see what they say and actually jump on Zoom calls with them and watch them use your tool?
All right, let's move on to one of my favorite tools that just got an update, Ollama. Yes, it's your ability to run large language models on your computer. Those of you that have been around a while on Creator Magic will know I've been running this for a long time on my server, but now I'm going to try it on my Mac Studio right here in front of me. You see, it can run latest models such as Qwen 3, so let's download. It works on Mac OS, also Linux, and Windows. And with the desktop app downloaded, let's install it. And this is really, really cool. Gemma 3 is an open source AI model from Google. Hello there, how are you? And I'm running this entirely locally on my Mac right now. You'll see first it needs to download the model. There we go, that didn't take too long, and now it's going to reply to me. Well, look at that, it's quite verbose. It's asking how I am and how's my day going so far. I want to stress this is 100% local and it's the cleanest app I've seen for running AI models on your computer. I'm doing absolutely fabulous. Tell me what the meaning of life is and reply in just two words. Find joy. It's a classic, isn't it? Well, yeah, technically, you replied in more than two words. Give me a list of ideas on how I can find joy this weekend. Okay, let's brainstorm, read a book, take a bath, listen to music, meditate, stargazing. Ooh, I like the idea of stargazing, and that's given me another idea. Let's go into the Ollama desktop app and look at all the different models we can download. Basically, if it's available from Ollama, you can download it. I'm really keen to try out Qwen, so let's download one model of Qwen, and we'll set it a task. Let's start a brand new chat, and you'll see nicely our chats are retained over here in the left-hand side, just as we'd expect with most AI apps. Write me some code for a simple page that will show a universe of stars bouncing around on screen in a wonderful, beautiful animation style. Okay, now you'll see Qwen 3 is thinking it through first. Okay, it really thought that through for nearly 50 seconds, and now it's given me some basic HTML. What is incredible about this is all this code is being written locally on my computer. I'm not touching the internet at all to get this response. So we'll copy the HTML. We'll save it onto my local device and double click. Boom! I gotta say, for locally written code, that really is not too bad at all. Well, that is it for this week. I really hope to see you in a future cohort of Ship Your App. Like I say, until the end of Sunday, super early bird pricing is open for Cohort 3, which starts in September. Also, regarding Lenny's newsletter, I thought this was such an incredible deal that I had to share it with you. Now, I've claimed it and got all of these deals, but some of them I couldn't use. As you're one of my loyal viewers watching all the way to the end, if you use the link down below to follow me on X, I'll be giving away one or maybe two coupons over the weekend to a lucky follower. And thank you so much for watching this week's video. I really appreciate you being there. I always enjoy doing these videos. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next.